Firstly, Harry loses his single main point of error, the infamous whiteboard, and hires a dedicated safety manager to oversee the safety management system.
Great, and you know, together we can work out some solutions.
Yep.
Great. He holds regular toolbox meetings with all his staff to actively seek out issues, creating action items and giving feedback.
Okay, well, from our last meeting, how are things working out with those new portable lights?
Mm. I mean, brilliant. It stands a lot, you can position them pretty easily. I think they've helped a lot. What do you guys reckon?
Yeah. That's great. That's okay. Well, on to today's agenda and a few things to cover. I know you're all keen to discuss how to improve shift handovers. I'd like to discuss the use of smartphones in the workplace.
He takes the time to listen to his staff, determining achievable deadlines and allowing them to do their jobs without distraction.
This one's US. I estimate it's going to take me the rest of the afternoon.
Okay.
And I want to finish it tomorrow in daylight. We started it. I prefer we finish it.
Yeah, yeah. No worries. I'll tell the owner it'll be a day longer.
Okay. I'll keep you posted if anything changes. Okay.
After talking to Roy, Harry takes control of the situation and calls Bruce, the owner of the aircraft.
Best. But I never make promises about when any job is going to be finished. I mean, you know that. And now we need to change the entire elevator trim drum assembly and... The rigging is a major job. It can't be rushed.
You really wouldn't want it any other way, would you, Bruce?
But I've got to get to Cunnamulla in the morning.
And I want you to get there safely. Bruce, I advised you from the very beginning how much time we'd need to get this work done. Look, if you need to be in Cunnamulla tomorrow, I'm more than happy to organise a charter.
Okay, go ahead and organise me a charter. At least I'll get there.
Good, take a seat.
Harry makes a time to talk to John, so he can speak to him about his timekeeping.
Discuss your timekeeping.
Mate, I've been sick, you know.
Yeah, things have been well, look, a bit... if that is the case, you should be at home. It's not fair on you or the others. You know, maybe you should see a doctor.
Yeah, I suppose. Fair enough. Look, I'm sorry. I'll work on it.
John, you're a big part of our team, mate. It's time to start leading by example, eh?
Yeah, no, understood. I will. I'll work on it and fix it.
Okay, great. Good mate.
All right, thanks again.
There's more attention paid to shift handovers, where there's a signed log kept and key points are communicated and understood by the incoming crew.
That's work, is it?
Yeah.
Okay,
good. Right. Make sure that's all done for tomorrow.
Yep, okay.
And it's all signed off.
All right, nice. Thanks very much.
All right.
Good. Have a good night.
See you, boys.
See you, boys.
John takes the time to brief Jason so he fully understands the task. Roy and Daniel do a duplicate inspection and check the elevator trim with an inclinator and communicate clearly with each other.
Up attitude.
Correct. Elevator trim is at its full extent, down for a nose up attitude.
Okay, the trim wheel is at full extent. The elevator trim is fully up, creating a nose down attitude.
Correct. Elevator trim is at its full extent, up for a nose down attitude.
Ultimately, it's the pilot in command's responsibility to check flight controls if they've been worked on before flight. What else could they do? Have a discussion amongst your group and write down other practices that could help Perfect Twins Maintenance build a better safety culture. One for me is that I think Harry should take a holiday with his family. A work-life balance is vital for all of us.